All right, let's do it. There's something later that's happening that is the reason why that is the way it is. thank y'all so much. Full of people who have risked life and limb to come and play and hang at the Abbey in Orlando, Florida. Thank you so much. Holy mackerel. I want to introduce you to my good friend, my best friend, Adam Beck, behind the drums. Adam. Holy shit. Adam, this is your 15th? This is Adam Beck's 15th show in Into It Over. During the madness, what has felt like what was 3 years, but actually felt like 40, we were able to write and release and put out a record in the year 2020, one of the spookiest years of all time. It's called Figure. And so Adam has been in the band. Adam has been playing Into It Over since May of 2017, and this is his 15th show. Holy shit, right? But so we want to play a couple songs from that record, and we're going to across the night, but this is one of them. It's about being stuck inside. This song's called We Prefer Indoors. Take it away.
Yeah. disappear. You're lost before you see. Flipping through the pages of our diary, memoirs worth of messages from you and me, both good and bad advice, recalling should-haves and could-haves, a distance from both of our worries. Pages of our diary. Thank you all so much. Who lives in Winter Park? I wrote a song about 11 years ago, and I've never played it in this town. We actually have not played it on this tour. We're only playing it tonight. And we'll see how it goes. We're gonna see how it goes. But this song's called Orlando, Florida.
Thank you.
You know, I've always considered Orlando kind of like our second home in the South, and played a lot of great shows at the Back Booth and at the Social and at Will's Pub. Feels really, really fortunate that we're able to be here in those, in a new place, somewhere I've never played before, but with friends like Tanner and Andy and the folks in Pool Kids, and feels like kind of a coming home, you know, like, it's something I can't describe. This song's a love song about being in the South. It's for Andy, it's for Christine, it's for Nicolette, it's for Tanner. It's for Tanner's parents, it's for Andy's parents. This song is called Living Up to Lay You Down.
Striking for tune on every hymn
Goodness gracious, you guys doing okay? Feeling safe, feeling supported? But in this room, I mean, not by the fucking country in general. We got your back.
My face just blurry memory. You must be kidding me. A person out of my gun.
Some people in this room have seen Into It Overplay, and you've watched this tune for about 20 fucking minutes, so the fact that we got Andy here is a big, big help.
Earlier my uncle said, that guy looks like the guy from What We Do in the Shadows, and I was like, that's exactly right, exactly right.
Wait, which guy? Which guy from What We Do in the Shadows? That's really fucking funny. All right, Joe, take it away.
Thank you.
So let's figure it out and write it down. Let's keep one last secret from everyone we know. Joe George on the guitar. Future is now, everybody. Late This is my good friend Joe George on the guitar to my right. Joe and I were having a conversation the other day. We were talking about songs, about what you write and how you write it, and how those songs can evolve and change and have different meanings over different times in your life. And you know, and we were talking about, you know, how certain songs that I wrote when I was 25, 23 mean something a whole lot different to me now that I'm 37. And this song specifically, you know, it wasn't really a big part of our set list as we were moving through the beginning of the tour, but over the course of the last week, it has become a really integral part of our set list. And the reason why is because the song has taken on new meaning for me personally in the time since it's been written. At the time that I wrote this song, it was about scene politics. It was about how something, you know, we were talking, like, Joe and I aren't religious people. I only speak for the two of us because we've had this conversation. Like, I don't believe in God, but... No, I mean, I'm not trying to talk shit on, or yuck anybody's yum. I'm not trying to talk shit on what anybody believes. But the fact of the matter is like, I don't have that kind of like spiritual bond that a lot of other people do. That being said, punk rock has always existed to me as kind of like that church. It represents community. It represents people that you know and love and care about. It represents a thing that you believe in that is bigger than yourself. And it always drove me crazy that people would try to gatekeep or fucking protect that like it's some sort of precious thing that not everybody could get involved or want to be involved in, right? So I wrote this song 11 years ago and it was about that. It was about this feeling of like being pissed off that people would try to keep people out of punk. Like, what a stupid fucking thought, you know? And it was about someone really specific at the time. Now we're in the year 2022. And it's feeling like a lot of other people are trying to gatekeep a lot of other things that are much more important than punk. Specifically, human rights, which is fucking driving me fucking crazy. It's driving me up a fucking wall. I should be driving you up a wall. This band aids and abets abortion. And we will do anything we can to support that and donate to that and be a part of that. Pool Kids brought a bunch of excellent fucking literature with them. I encourage you to pick it up. I encourage you to donate and support your local charities and causes and communities. I support this is a room of love. We are a tour of love and support, and we love everyone in this room. We care about you, and we're looking out for you. And this song is about that. It's about redefining that relationship. This is my good friend Matt Frank on the bass guitar. Matt and I play in a band together called There, There, There. More on that later this year. Hopefully we see you folks at Fest. So now you've met the band. And so for the first time in 15 years, Intuitover, it's been a project for about 15 years at this point. For the first time in all of that time, Intuitover is now a band. It is no longer me, it is the four of us. We split everything evenly, we make decisions democratically. And we write songs together. Recently, about in May, we released a split LP with our good friends in a band called Hikes. Maybe you saw them here with a band called Public. So this song is about riding your bike with your best friends in the woods during the craziest summer of all time, and it's called The Designated Place at the Designated Time.
While music is falling, every bell on the drum.
shit got stuck underneath the pickup I was rocking so. That's a good thing. It's about time I rocked that fucking hard. 37-year-old ass. Who's been seeing Into It Over for a real long time? Who saw me play the Cassettes House in Melbourne, Florida? Anybody see that shit? All right. You don't need to blind these poor people with the fucking lights. Holy shit.
I mean, it's really nice to see everyone, though. You like that, bro?
It's okay. It's okay. This is a super fucking old one, and I want to let Joe fucking dance his ass off on stage. This is his fucking time to shine. I'm gonna judge your view of Joe's dancing based on their fucking hooting and hollering that y'all do. So if I can hear y'all, I know he's doing a good job. So much. Do not leave. We have something very special planned for you. Wow. Unbelievably fortunate to work on a couple records for a band from here called You Blew It. Really, really, really fortunate to be able to work on two records called Keep Doing What You're Doing and Haven't Dry. And we want to invite Andy and Tanner up here on stage, and we're going to play some You Blew It songs for you.
That is so embarrassing.
that's my donation to the Abbey, I guess.
Thanks for sticking around.
Joking.
band practice.
Not bad. This is really cool. Looks just like somebody I know, and he's here tonight. We've only played like one You Blew It song per, I don't know, couple shows, but we're gonna play a bunch, so thank you for being here.
I'm usually
yeah, you were. Should we play a few more? Thank you. Shouts out to Joe and and Matt for letting us do this and take up some of our time.
No grand statement, just fuck. Just fuck. We have two songs left. the last one. I want to thank Edwin over it, Evan, Joe, Matt, Adam, everyone for doing this.
Also, Cool Kids for being the best goddamn band in the land.
Thank you guys, please get home safe.
So much.